So I've never really shied away from giving my opinion on Kyrie Irving, and I for the most part think he's one of the most talented players in the entire league. He absolutely mesmerizes me every single time I have the pleasure of watching him. He reminds me a lot like Allen Iverson, only he really goes more in depth and in detail with the way he sizes his opponents up. And his finishing ability is just so much, I don't want to say better, but it's so silky smooth. It's really just a phenomenal game to watch. And the one critique I've always had on Kyrie Irving is pretty much what's going on in his head psychologically. And like, I've never shied away from this. I think there's been a couple of videos where I've went in depth on this, but it's pretty much, I've called Kyrie Irving spoiled before, and that's because I feel like he literally came into the league onto one of the worst franchises historically, like probably the most cursed franchise in the NBA, in the Cleveland Cavaliers. And he was expected to shoulder the burden of that rebuild, which, come on, let's be honest, it wasn't going to be successful, man. Like, look at the Cavs. Look at who they drafted after Kyrie Irving. You had Tristan Thompson, Dion Waiters, Andrew Wiggins, Anthony Bennett. That, come on, think about that core really quickly, man. Like, at first, I'm not going to lie, I'm going to 100% back this up and own up to this. I felt like Andrew Wiggins was going to be a star. He was really hyped up coming out of college. I thought he was going to be the next Tracy McGrady. But if you look back at that core, it wasn't going to work out. So what happens? LeBron James comes back and literally boosts the Cleveland Cavaliers to a title contender. And what that ended up doing was, well, of course, they did go to the NBA Finals the first year. Injuries hampered their chances of winning the NBA Finals. We know what happened with Kyrie Irving getting injured, and the Golden State Warriors would win their first championship. But the very next year, in a year where everyone thought that the Cleveland Cavaliers had no chance of beating the Golden State Warriors, who were 73-9, they came back from a 3-1 deficit. Kyrie Irving won his first championship, and LeBron James finally brought a ring to Cleveland. However, this wasn't enough for Kyrie Irving. He wanted to have his own team, and he got that. He got to be the face of the Boston Celtics franchise. And then he went to Boston, and apparently he didn't want to be the face of that franchise. I don't know what happened. He said that he had some personal issues with his family, and that affected his judgment, so he wanted to be close to home. But I can't help but feel like I could kind of sympathize with Kyrie, because when I feel like he's kind of like a teenager or a college student trying to really find himself, trying to find what he wants in the NBA, when he needs to take a step back and say, hey, I've accomplished a lot. I'm a former rookie of the year. You know, I've won an NBA championship. I was good enough to beat one of the greatest, if not the greatest team in NBA history. And I think we could go ahead and call the Golden State Warriors of that year one of the greatest, if not the greatest team in NBA history, although they couldn't get it done. You know what I mean? They couldn't win a championship. Regardless, if you go 73-9 in the regular season, then that's saying something. So what's going on, guys? Your boy, The Flight Mike, back again with another video. And again, I have been paying attention to your comments about how long the intro is, so I am going to try to keep this under 20 seconds. So if you're new to my channel and you watch a lot of my content, you haven't hit that subscribe button yet, please take a moment to hit that subscribe button, because when I hit 500,000 subscribers, I will get to be a full-time YouTuber. It's been my dream to be a full-time YouTuber. I wake up every day at 6 in the morning to make content for you guys. I absolutely love it, man. It is so much fun. So if you guys could, I appreciate the gift of being able to make you guys content, but if you guys could take that extra step and subscribe, I would definitely appreciate it. Also, we're doing a giveaway for a pair of Off-White Air Jordan 1s because I just hit 10,000 followers on Instagram. So if you wanted to enter in that giveaway, I'm going to leave it in the description down below. Also, huge shout out to my Patreon patrons. We got a new one the other day. Shout out to Kevin, Grant, and Icy Jaylen Brown Twitter. Thank you guys for supporting me on Patreon. If you want to support my channel financially, there's a link to it in the description down below to get shouted out just like them. But I would much, much rather you guys turn on my notifications than ever support me financially at all. I don't expect it. I was a broke college student. I 100% get it. So now that I kept that intro to about a minute and 20 seconds, which is an improvement, I hope that's an improvement, and just know I'm always going to try to improve for you guys, I want to talk about something that I saw last night. And this just perplexed me as I was watching. I was watching this incredible performance by Kyrie Irving. And Kyrie Irving had a lot of people on his team, including Andrew Wiggins. He probably thought that he was still a member of Kyrie's team. You know, they were on Cleveland for one summer together, even though they've never took the court officially together. They were on Cleveland for one summer together. And Andrew Wiggins, I don't know if you guys were paying attention to this, my man went minus 28. He was a negative 28, which means the Brooklyn Nets should have been absolutely blown out last night. But Andrew Wiggins literally kept them in it. It's crazy. I don't know what helped them more, Kyrie Irving's 50 or Andrew Wiggins' negative 28, but Karl Anthony Towns went off. And I was watching this game and I was thinking, dang, like, Kyrie is literally backpacking the Brooklyn Nets right now. I've never seen anything like this in my life. Like, well, I have, but it's pretty incredible to watch. And at the same time, it wasn't enough. He was not able to get one last, like, one go-ahead shot to go. He got a pretty decent look, a look that he could have made. It was like about at the free throw line. And I'm just thinking to myself at this point, man, Kyrie Irving is in for a very long year. Because in my opinion, the Minnesota Timberwolves didn't get that much better over the past year. They're pretty much more or less the same exact team that they were the year before. Give or take a couple of players, they added Shabazz Napier, they added Jordan Bell, you know, they have Jared Culver now. More or less, unless if one of those players ends up like really finding their role in Minnesota, they are pretty much the same exact team that they were last year. And hopefully, you know, a whole offseason in Ryan Saunders' scheme is going to make a difference. But for the most part, I saw a lot of things that were the same. Karl Anthony Towns was carrying Minnesota's offense. Andrew Wiggins was doing his best to tank him. And for the most part, I saw the same exact team as I did last year. Now, kudos to them. They got a victory, you know. Really, like, they really fought hard and well in that game. But I don't view, what I'm trying to say is I don't view Minnesota as a top-tier team at all. Because, again, they just seem very similar to the team last year. Unless if Jared Culver is just an absolute beast, which could totally be the case. But what I'm trying to say here is Kyrie Irving went off for 50. And honestly, the next best man up was Caris LeVert. He went for 20. Joe Harris went for 14. Taurean Prince went for 15. The Minnesota Timberwolves, meanwhile, it was a little bit more spread out. Cat had 36. Andrew Wiggins had 21, but he shot terribly from the field. What I'm trying to say here is Kyrie Irving is in for a very long year, and I really am curious to see how he's going to react to this. If he wasn't happy being the guy in Boston, and if he wasn't happy being LeBron James's sidekick, he gets to play mini leader this year. He pretty much gets to play like leader while he waits for Kevin Durant to come back, but he clearly needs some help. He definitely needs more help on the offensive end and even the defensive end. If you're letting the Minnesota Timberwolves push the pace to the point where they're scoring 127 to 126 on you guys, then defensively, there needs to be some adjustments as well. I feel like Kyrie Irving is going to be in for one very long year, and I just can't help but feel like maybe, perhaps down the line, there may be some heads clashing in Brooklyn, if history is any indication. I hope I'm wrong, because I feel like when Kyrie Irving and Kevin Durant fully fulfill their promise and potential, they're going to be an absolutely captivating tandem to watch on the court. Now, I said this in the summer, I'm going to keep saying this, I really feel like the Brooklyn Nets should take a shot and sign Carmelo Anthony. They could have definitely used his scoring prowess last night. The Timberwolves were scoring the amount that they were going to score anyways. I know he's a defensive liability, but signing Carmelo Anthony wouldn't mean that the Timberwolves would have scored 135 last night as opposed to 127. But it would mean that Kyrie Irving would have had some help, another person to lean on down the stretch, a player that could definitely close some games. The number one knock on Carmelo Anthony is he can't play NBA level defense. It doesn't matter at this point, honestly, because the Nets are not a championship caliber team until Kevin Durant steps on the floor. they sign Carmelo Anthony, and they do have another scorer to assist Kyrie Irving, maybe take the burden off of him when he goes to the bench. I feel like the Nets should take a shot on Carmelo because they have nothing to lose at this point. Very, very worst case, best case, Kevin Durant comes back next year and Carmelo Anthony goes to the bench and you have a great bench scorer. You know, or worst case this year, you probably hit the eighth seed in the East. It doesn't really matter because I don't think the Nets are going to go all the way in the Eastern Conference anyways. Why not take a shot and give Carmelo Anthony a chance to really show what he could do in the league today? That's a little bit of a bold take. I would really like to get your guys' input on this. What do you guys think? Do you think Kyrie Irving needs some help? Do you think some adjustments need to be made? Do you think the Nets are fine the way they are? Who do you blame last night's loss on? Do you think it was the fact that Kyrie's teammates didn't step up? Or do you think that the Timberwolves are probably like a much better team this year? I would really like to hear your opinions and what you guys have to say. Thanks for watching.